Good morning, children. Today, let us see how to find the square root of a number by long division method. In the previous exercises, you have learned how to find the square root of a number by factorization, that is a prime factorization method. So, let us proceed now. For finding long division method, you have to remember this table now. So, when the square of the number has even number of zeros, the unit digit of a number will be 0. When the unit digit of a square number is 4, you can try it either by 2 or 8. When the unit digit of a square number is 9, you can try with 3 or 7. When the unit digit of a square number is 6, you can try with 4 or 6. When the unit digit of a square number is 5, you can try with 5. So, you should always remember this table in mind whenever you do the square root by long division method. Another important rule is that before starting, mark off the digits in pairs from right to left. So, this point you have to remember. When there is a number without decimal point, this integral part is always marked in pairs from right to left. To do it, let us place a bar on every pair. For example, if you have a number 625, I am going to pair it as 25 together and 6 separately. Suppose if you have a number 2025, 25 is paired as a single number and 20 is paired as another number. The pairing is always started from right to left. You have to start from the extreme right hand corner. This point you should remember. You should not pair it from the beginning. You should pair it from the end, right to left. Similarly, if you are having the number 12996, it is paired as 96, 29 and 1. So, you always put a bar on this so that you remember these two numbers has to be dropped down together. Now, let us see how to find the square root of a three-digit number by long division method. So, for example, let us take the number 625. In this 625, first step is always used to pair the numbers by putting a bar over the number. So, first I am going to pair these two numbers 25. I am going to put a bar over this number 25. Next, now 6 is left out. So, I am going to put one bar over this 6 now. This is the first step. Second step. In the second step, while looking at this first number is 6. So, now I am going to find the square number less than or equal to 6 in this table. I am not having 6 in this table. So, I am going to take an immediate square number less than 6. So, which is nothing but 4. 4 is nothing but 2 into 2, 4. I should always take equal factors. So, 1, 2 I will be writing in the divisor. And another 2 I will be writing in the quotient. And you can check also 2 into 2 is equal to. I will be writing 2 into 2, 4 which is below 6 over here. Now I will subtract 6 minus 4. 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. And after this, the third step will be I have to drop down these paired numbers. What is the paired numbers over here? 25. So, now my number is 225. Next step will be I have to add this quotient to this divisor. This is nothing but 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. After adding, again I have to choose a same factor over there in the quotient and as well as in the divisor. Since my last digit, since all the digits are over here and I am able to see my last digit is 5 over here. So, whenever there is a 5 in the unit place, I said the equal factors will be 5 into 5. So, I will take 1 5 in the divisor and another 5 in the quotient. So, now 45 into 5 will be 25 and when I subtract these two numbers, I am getting the remainder as 0. Therefore, square root of 625 will be equal to 25. This process is repeated and until I complete all the digits over there in the given number. Hope you understood this method. Now let us see one more example of a three-digit number. Now let us consider a number 729. So first step, group the numbers, put the bar over the number from the right hand side. This is very important. So I have grouped the number 29, I have put a bar over this number 29, and 7 is left out, so I have put one bar over 7 also. Now the second step will be, I have to find a square number less than or equal to 7 in this table. So square number less than or equal to 7, that is immediate square number is 4. Therefore 2 into 2 is equal to 4. So 1, 2 I'll be writing in the divisor, second 2 I'll be writing in the quotient. Always these two numbers should be same. Now 2 into 2 is equal to 4. Now you subtract 4 to 3. Now drop down the next two numbers 29. So my number is now 329. After this, I have to add this quotient to the, which is nothing but 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. After adding, always write the equal factors over here to get this number either 329 or less than this number 329. Either it should be equal or it can be less than this number. Since there is a 9 in the unit place, 9 is got either by putting 3 into 3 or 7 into 7. So I can try both the numbers, either 43 into 3 or 47 into 7. Whichever answer is suitable for you, you can add this number over here. So I am going 7 over here, that is 47 into 7. So 47 into 7 will give 329. After subtracting, I am getting 329 minus 329 will give me 0. Therefore, square root of 729 is equal to 27. Now, let us see a 4-digit number. How to find the square root of a 4-digit number? So, first step, put a bar over the number, pair the numbers. So, I put bar over 25 and 20 over here. Now I have to choose a square number less than or equal to 20. My immediate square number less than or equal to 20 is 16, which is nothing but 4 into 4, 16. So 1, 4 I'll be writing in the divisor, another 4 I'll be writing in the quotient. Now what is 4 into 4? 16. After writing 16, you and then drop down the next two numbers. So my number is now 425. My next step will be, I have to add this quotient with the, so 4 plus 4 is 8. After adding, don't forget, you should always choose the same equal factor, that is same factor over one factor in quotient, another factor in divisor. Since my all the digits are over here, you can see the unit place over here. Unit place is 5. So I will choose 5 into 5 equal to 25. Here also the unit place is 5. Unit digit is 5. So my factor will be 5 and 5. So 85 into 5 is equal to 425. 425 minus 425 is equal to 0. Therefore, square root of 2025 is equal to 45. Hope you understood how to find the square root by long division method for a 3-digit number and a 4-digit number. Now let us take one 5-digit number. Now let us see how to find the square root of a 4-digit number. So the first step, pair the numbers and put a bar over this number. So first bar is over 56, second 79, third 1. So my first step is to place 1 over here, because the first number is 1. I have to write a square number less than or equal to 1. Since 1 into 1 is 1, I am writing 1 into 1 is 1. Subtract. After subtracting, I am getting the answer as 79. And you have to add this 1 with this number. That is, the quotient is added with this divisor. So I am getting 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Now you are able to see this is not the last number over here. Still my digits are left out. So I have to choose some number over here such that my number is less than. If I multiply these two numbers, this number with the quotient, my answer should be less than 79. You can also guess this by, since you are having 7 over here, I should get a number less than 7. So I will try with 22 by placing 2 over here and 3 over here, because you know 2 3s are 6 and 6 is less than 7. Suppose if I take 4 over here, you know 4 2s are 8, which is greater than 7. So the only option left out is I can either try with 3 or 2. With 3, so while trying with 3, I am able to observe 23 into 3 is equal to 69. Then you subtract these two numbers, I am getting 10. After subtracting, drop down the next paired numbers, which is 56 over here. After getting the subtracted value, my next step is to add this quotient over. Only 3 is added, don't add 13. The immediate quotient is always added. So now I am going to add this 3 with this 23. After adding 3 with this 23, I am getting 26. So next time I'll try with this 4. So that 26, if I 264, I am taking 4 over here. So 264 into 4 will give me 1056. So if I subtract, I am getting the answer as 0. Therefore, square root of 17956 is equal to 134. Hope you understood this long division method. You take some more examples and try this method.